Beloved, we are gathered here as the people of God to witness the marriage of Alexis and Graham. We come to share in their joy and to ask God to bless them. Marriage is a gift of God sealed by a sacred covenant, and God gives human love. Through that love, husband and wife come to know each other with mutual care and companionship. God gives joy, and through joy, husband and wife may share their new life with others. With our love and our prayers and a couple of tears, we support Graham and Alexis as they now freely give themselves to each other. Will you join me in prayer? Gracious God, always faithful in your love for us, we rejoice in your presence. You create love. You unite us in one human family. You offer your word and lead us in light. You open your loving arms and embrace us with strength. May the presence of Christ fill our hearts with new joy and make new the lives of your servants whose marriage we celebrate. Bless all creation through this sign of your love, shown in the love of Alexis and Graham. May the power of your Holy Spirit sustain them and all of us in love that knows no end. Amen. Our first reading today comes from the Old Testament, the book of Ecclesiastes, chapter 4. Two are better than one, because they have a good reward for their toil. For if they fall, one would lift the other up. But woe to one who is alone and falls, and has no one to help. Again, if two lie together, they keep warm. But how can one keep warm alone? And though one might prevail against another, two will withstand one. And a cord of three strands is not easily broken. Our New Testament reading comes from John's first letter, chapter 4. This is how we stay one with God and are sure God loves us, for God is love. And if we keep on loving others, we will stay one in our hearts with God, and God will stay with us. Because if we truly love others and live as Christ did in this world, we don't need to worry about judgment. Because a real love for others will chase those worries away. The thought of being punished is what makes us afraid, and it shows that we have not really learned to love. We love because God first loved us. Amen. Anytime there is love, God is there. And anytime there is joy, God is there. And right now, I have got so much love and joy at this moment. Are you with me here?
Yes.
I know this is an elegant ceremony. I have so much love and joy. Amen?
Amen.
Lexis and Graham, I want you just to take a moment and look out at all these people, because we love you both so much. And we are so honored that you invited us to be here on this day. What began at the opera program at UMSL has now blossomed into what you said is the light of my life. From the beginning, you two have formed a strong bond of friendship and love. You've handled the challenges, you've found joy in all things. You have loved each other and your family with a fierce loyalty, and we are proud of you, and we are filled with such love at this moment. Now, up to this point, all the work has been in your hands, the preparation for this wedding, along with the school graduations. But now, at this moment, the ceremony shifts to all of you, the family and friends of Alexis and Graham. They have asked you to be here for a reason. They want you to witness their vows, and not just as an excuse to go to the reception later and have a lovely time. They're asking you to make a promise with them. Alexis and Graham have asked that you witness these promises that they will make, and that you make a pledge and commitment yourself, that you will promise to partner with both of them through this marriage. So today, you are promising to this couple that they will not have to do it alone, that you will encourage them, support them, listen to them, love them, and pray for them. You're going to promise to help them not quit when life gets tough. What I love about the scripture we heard today is that they remind us that love is sacrifice. Love is caring for others before yourself, and love can be really hard work, but it's the path to joy. And we celebrate that this marriage has such a strong foundation of friendship supporting it, and that we've all seen the seed of joy begin to grow. So all of us here promise to support both of you. Individually, you are two of the most amazing people I have met, and together you bring out the best in each other. Together you'll face the worst. And with God as the third cord in your strand, you will be ungrateful. You will be tested, and we all promise to come alongside you with our friendship, our vows, and our love and support when things get rough. And all of Alexis and Graham's family and friends agreed and said, amen.
Amen.
So before God and these people, I'm going to ask you to affirm your willingness to enter this covenant of marriage, to share all the joys and sorrows of the new relationship, whatever the future brings. Graham, will you have Alexis to be your wife? And will you love her faithfully as long as you both shall live? If so, answer, I will with the help of God.
I will with the help of God.
You would think for an opera person that might have been a little louder, but we all know he said yes. He said that. Alexis, will you have Graham be your husband? And will you love him faithfully as long as you both shall live? If so, answer, I will with the help of God.
I will with the help of God.
Now you were nervous about saying it loud enough, don't you? To the parents of Graham and Alexis, do you offer your prayerful blessing and loving support of this marriage and this family? If so, say, I do. Do you, the people of God, promise your support and encouragement to the covenant commitment that Alexis and Graham are making to each other and to the family they will make? If so, say, we do.
We do.
Alexis and Graham, you can wait for this moment. You may now hold each other's hands. And you're going to speak your covenant promises that you have brought up before you. Give me a second.
To my Alexis, I love you now more than ever. From your witty humor to your unending spontaneity, you never fail to make each day a brighter opportunity to do good in the world. Each waking moment we spend together, I prove your dedication and love to our happiness and success in life. From the day we met, I knew we'd be best friends. From the City Museum to dinner on the hill, those first few days taught me all I needed to know. To grow with you by leaps and bounds has been one of the most exciting things in my life. Each day that passes is a new journey, and I choose no other to walk with than you. I pray our future will hold only the best. I cannot wait to start a family with you. One day we will sit around the table and think back on this glorious time. I promise to be with you through all life has to offer. I also promise to make you the best of breakfast sandwiches that I can do. I promise to do all I can protect you. I promise to do all I can to protect you from thick and thin. And I promise to hear you in your every wish and desire and be connected as one along the way. But most of all, as long as we both shall live, I will be the best partner I can, and I will give you my love. I love you, Alexis.
I may need some Kleenex up here.
Yeah.
All right. Graham, I stand before you today, humbled that God chose me to be your wife, and grateful that our journey led us to the altar today. I've always been the anxious person that has a tendency to question everything. So when we became friends at 19 years old, I felt this overwhelming and undeniable sense of safety and peace that I still feel with you to this day. I knew that our friendship is something that is bigger than the stars. I remember talking to God several months after we met and saying how grateful I was for you and asking God to keep you in my life forever in whatever form that presented itself. Well, today is a true testament to God's faithfulness in my life. Because here we are in the most beautiful church, surrounded by the people we love most, about to become one in the eyes of God and the family by law. And I can't help but imagine how special it is that we get to experience this life at one another's side. And how beautiful it will be to watch one another become parents and travel to new places and discover new dreams and all of the other exciting gifts of life. couple months ago, I heard a saying that I strongly detested at the time. It said, to love someone forever is to attend a funeral of thousands of versions of that person. And I hated the saying at the time because it sounded so morbid to me. And because I like to believe there's a truly consistent version to each person I live for. But when I think of saying it in the context of our relationship, it's actually super hopeful and exciting and fruitful. Because in the 6 years that we've known each other and the 5 years that we've been together, I've met probably 50 versions of you, and you've met at least 100 versions of me. And you've grown more in love with each new introduction to one another. I've loved every version of you. And I stand before God and our friends and family today, vowing to love and care for every version of you that I have the privilege to meet after we walk out of this church today. I promise to never stop growing with you. I promise to always do my best to protect you and love you with everything that I have. I promise to be your safe place to land when the roads of life become too harsh. And among my many promises to be your safe place, I also promise to challenge you to be the best friend, son, husband, and parent that you can be. Not just because I really like to annoy you, but also because I've seen your greatness and I know the pure intentions of your soul. Lastly, I promise to remind you of the beauty of life when hurdles blind your path, and to be your support in times of loss and failure and grief and hardship. My devotion to you is eternal, and my love for you is undying. Here's to all the days after.
Joking about how your vows were longer than my sermon, but they were better than the sermon.
Man, these evidence.
By these symbols of covenant promise, gracious God, remind Alexis and Graham of your encircling love and your unending faithfulness that in all their life together, they may know the joy and peace that can be found in one another. So, Graham, I want you to take this. And I want you to repeat after me. Alexis, I give you the drink as a sign of my love and faithfulness. So, let's repeat after me. Graham, I give you this ring as a sign of my love and faithfulness. Those whom God has joined together, let no one separate. Graham and Alexis, you are wife and husband with the blessing of Christ Church. Be merciful in all your ways, kind in heart, and humble in mind. Accept life and be most patient and tolerant with one another. Forgive as freely as God has forgiven you. And above everything else, be truly loving. Let the peace of Christ rule in your hearts, remembering that as members of one body, we are called to live in harmony, and never forget to be thankful for what God has done for you. Ecclesiastes 4 reminds us that two are better than one, and a cord of three strands cannot be broken. So today we celebrate these two becoming one, and the joining of these two families under the umbrella of God's unending love. So I invite up Roseanne and Devin, the mothers, to bring their light of their own family stories as Lexis and Graham use them now to start their family story.
May the grace of Christ attend you, the love of God surround you, and the Holy Spirit keep you, that you may grow in holy love, find delight in each other always, and remain faithful until your life's end. Beloved, let us pray together. Most gracious God, we give you thanks for your tender love. You sent Jesus Christ to come among us, to be born of a human mother, who showed compassion and care for those who were cast aside, who spoke words of justice and healed the broken. You danced at wedding feasts, and you blessed each family who came to you. By the power of your Holy Spirit, pour out the abundance of your blessing on Graham and Alexis. Defend them from every enemy. Lead them into all peace. Let their love for each other be a seal on their hearts, a mantle about their shoulders, and a crown on their head. Bless them in their work and their companionship, in their sleeping and in their waking, in their joys and in their sorrows, in their lives and in their final death. Nurture them in a community of the faithful gathered about you. All of this we ask in your holy name. It gives me such joy and pleasure to introduce to you, for the first time, Mr. and Mrs. Graham and Alexis Hayden. You may now kiss your bride.
This is where the good part begins. We invite you.